Friend, today I want to explain you exercise 2.5. So today
the scan is completed.
Today discuss related with the exercise 2.5. So already we have learned in last lecture all important 8 identities. So if we know identity properly, now we can solve this sum. So here it is related with the identity x plus a and x plus b. So first I write the identity and then I explain whole sum. So this formula we have applied to solve this sum. So now if we start, so here what I have to write, x plus 4 plus x plus 10, therefore x square 4 plus 10 x 4 into 10, therefore x square plus 14x plus 14. Same thing you can now do it by yourself, question 2 and 3. But again, same example, same formula we have to write this. Now, this is first sum. Now, second sum. When you are visualizing this video, on that time you have to make a rough book with you. And you have to write all the sum, whatever I am explaining. So again, x square plus 8 minus 10 x plus 8 into minus 10. So x square minus 2x minus 18 plus 8 minus 10 plus minus minus. Here in multiplication, 8 into minus 10, that is minus 8. Now third sum, again same formula, that is x plus a x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b bracket over x plus a into b. Now if I will write it here, 3x plus 4 and 3x minus 5. Here it is 3x whole to square plus in bracket plus 4 minus 5 bracket over, and in bracket we have to write 3x plus 4 into minus 5. So here it is 9x square plus minus 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 1 plus 4 minus 5, that is minus 1. Minus 1 into 3x, so minus 3x. And 4, 5 is 20, minus 20. So in exercise 2.5, question number 1, here there are 5 sums. Out of 5, I have completed it here 2 sums. So 3 sums, sorry. So first again, which identity we have to use? X plus A, x plus b is equal to x square in bracket a plus b x plus ab. This is the identity we have used. Now x plus a x plus 10. So how we can do? First formula is x square, so here it is x. Second a plus b, so here it is a, here it is b. So I have to put in bracket 4 plus 10 x and 4 into 10, here a into b, so x square plus 4x plus 14. In second, x plus 8, x minus 10. So a is equal to 8 and b is equal to minus 10. Again same formula, x square plus 8 minus 10 bracket over x, again here it is plus. So always remember that minus 10 plus 8, I have to write minus 2. So that is why I am writing minus 2. Again here it is x now. So here it is not x only but 3x. So we have to make a square of it. So 3 square is 9. So 9, and here it is a, here it is b. So a into b, that is minus 20. So in this exercise there are 16 sums is there. So if we can solve all 16 sums thoroughly, then it is not possible. So what is my plan, that in first video or in exercise 2.5 first lecture we can complete 5 sums, next again 5 sums, and next again 5 sums. So we can easily, now you have to write this, you have to write this all these sum. Next, now question, evaluate the following product without multiplying directly. Evaluate the following product without multiplying directly. So generally whatever student, what they are doing, they are multiplying directly, but that is not a way. What they use? Without. So we have to use the identities. Now how we can know that which identity we have to use? So there are 8 different identities, out of which you will see, now here 100, 103, 107. So what I am writing? 100 plus 3. And 100 plus 7. So now we can apply x plus a here, x plus b. So same identity which are we have applied in question number 1. In question number 1, there are 3 questions. So in this we have used the identity. So a plus b, x plus a into b. So again now as x we can take 100, here we can take a, again here x, here b. So 100 plus 3, that is x, a, 100 plus 7, x and b. So here x square means what we have to do is 100 square, a plus b, so 3 plus 7, x means 100 plus 3 into 7. So 100 square is 10,000, 3 plus 7, 10, 10 into 100, that is 1000, plus 7, 3 are 21. So I have to add these all. So 1000. So 1000, what I am writing it here, 1000, 10,000 and 21. So 1, 2, 0, 1, 1. So answer is 1, 1, 0, 2, 1. So what I am doing, you can also check it, that is your answer is correct or not, then we can do it by. But simple concept is you have to use the formula. Which formula I am using at here? X plus a, x plus b, then 100 plus 3. So someone says, sir, can we write 105? Now another way I am solve this same sum, we can do it by this method also. 103, again I am writing it here. So I am writing 105 minus 2, 105 plus, that way also we can do 105 minus 2, 105 plus 2. For this what I have to do? X minus Y, X plus Y. So we can use this identity also at here. So x square minus y square. So we can use 105 whole to square minus 2 square. Now 105 square is 110, 25. 1 0 is 5 square, already we have learned in 8th standard. Unit base is 5. So 5 square is 25. 10 and then 11. After 10, which digit is come? 11. So 10, 11 is 110. Minus 4. So 1, 1, 0, 2. So you will see that two different identities we can use to solve this sum. This is also a one type of identity. It is also a identity. Same here I am writing it here. It is also a identity. So two different identity we can solve this sum. So again you have to write continue when I am explaining. You have your rough book with and we can easily solve. So I am rough this and then I am explain again. Now, so second question is there. Three in each question, there is a one or two sums. So I am explaining old sum. But you have to go through old lecture proper and you have to comment because up to August it is not possible to start our school. But you have a problem, you can WhatsApp to me. So now 95 into so chalo. So now 95 into 96. So 90 plus 5 and 90 plus 6. 90 plus 5, 90 plus 6. So again 90 square. 5 plus 6, 90 plus 5 into 6. So 90 square is 8100. Here it is 11, 5 plus 6, 11 into 9, 990 plus 30. So 8100, 990 and 30. So answer is 0, 2, carry 1, 10, 11, carry 1. So 9, 1, 2, 0. So 9, 1, 2, 0 is the answer. Again I repeat, which identity I am using? X plus A, X plus B is equal to X square, A plus B, X plus A into B. Now one more sum still now remaining. First I am rub this. Now again this sum we can do it by two different ways. Either 100 plus 4, 100 minus 4, or we can say 100 plus 4. So we can do it by both way, we get same answer. So 104 multiplied by 96. So what you have to write? 100 plus 4 and 100 minus 6. 104 plus 6. And it, what we have to do? We have to apply both formula. We can do it by both formula. That is 100 plus 4, 100 minus 4. So we can apply 100 square and 4 square. So 100 square is 10,000. 4 square is 16. So 9,984. Another way is what? Same, X plus A, X plus B. On that time, X square, A plus B, x plus 8. We can do it by same method. So here 100 whole to square plus 4 minus 4. Here it is 100 and 4 into minus 4. So here again 10,000. Here it is 0. So 0 multiply any number, answer is 0. So minus 16. Here answer is 0. So only this will be 16. So 10,000 minus 16, again 9984. So second question, again I am explaining with example. Now question number 3. For 5 sums anyhow we have to do. So now identity, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Answer is a plus b whole to square. So again I am writing at here 3x whole to square 2 into in bracket 3x second bracket y plus y square. So now from here we have to take 3x, from here I have to take y, from middle I have to take plus and then write whole to square. Now here 4y square minus 4y plus 1. Again 2y whole to square minus 2 into 2y into 1 plus 1 square. So 2y minus 1 whole to square. It is a standard formula already we have completed. So it is easy. A square plus 2ab plus b square is equal to a plus b whole to square. Now here x square minus y square. So difference of square x plus y, x minus y. So what I have to write? X whole to square and y upon 10 whole to square. So x minus y upon 10, x plus y upon 10. So these are all the easy, just we have to write the identity. Now fourth sum, it is important. Now here it is a power 2 is there. Again power 2. When 3 term is there and power 2, we have to write the answer 6 term. So I am writing it here a plus b plus c whole to square formula. So a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Same formula we can apply it here. So first step is what? First 3 terms square. So x square 2y square plus 4z square plus now 2ab. So 2 into x into b plus 2 into 2y into z plus 2 into 4z into x. So how many terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 terms are there. Now, so x square plus 4y square plus 16z square plus 2 to the 4. So 4xy plus 2 to the 4. 4 for the 16. 16yz plus 4 to the 8xz. So how many terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 terms. Same thing we can do in this also. Same thing we can do in this. So now I am not writing the formula, I am directly solve the sum. 3x whole to square plus here negative sign, so it we have to write in bracket plus z square plus 2 into 2x into minus y plus 2 into minus y minus z plus 2 into z and 2x. So I have to write answer 4x square plus y square plus z square to 2 jar 4xy minus 2yz plus 2 into z into 2x plus 4xz. So same way you can also do this. Again power is 4, what you have to write? 3 power, when power is twice and inside 3 brackets are, 3 terms are there, then which formula you have to use? A square plus a plus b plus c equal to square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Next question. Now it is inverse of it. First I am writing the question at here, formula x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2zx plus, sorry, here yz 2yz plus 2xz. Then I can write the formula x plus y plus z whole square. Same thing we have to do it here. So now 4x square plus 9y square. So here it is a square of 2. So 2x square, first three term is always perfect square. So 3y square plus 4z square. Now so first three terms are perfect square. So we have to write. Now second 2 into first term and second term I have to write. So 2x and 3y. So first term, second term, third term, perfect square, fourth term, 2 into first term, second term, fifth term, 2 into second term and third term, so 3y and 4z, and 2 into 4z and 2x. So here it is a square of first three term is over answer. Always remember, first three term is over answer. Now important thing is where I have to put negative sign. So here, which is the common variable between these two negative sign? Here negative sign is common in y. Variable is y is common, z is common, sorry. So z is common, so wherever there is a z, I have to write minus. Wherever there is a z, I have to write minus. And here, instead of, I have to write minus. So I first rub it. I have to rub this. Now I have to write minus. So important is which sign we have to put negative. So when two negative signs are there, always two negative signs. Between them we have to find out the common variable. Again same it is. Here it is 2x square. So I have to write root 2x whole to square plus y whole to square plus 8. So 2 root 2 square. 2 root 2 square is always 8. And I have to write z whole to square plus 2 into first term, that is 2x. Second term, now negative sign is between whom? Minus, z is negative. X is negative because common variable is x. So I have to write minus sign at here. Again minus sign at here. Y plus 2 into second term, third term. Plus 2 into third term and first term. So here root 2 square is 2x square, y square is y. 2 root 2 square is always 8. Here it is 2 root 2. Here it is 2 root 2. Here it is 4 root 2. So again 2 root 2, 4 root 2 to the 4, and here it is 8. So answer is minus root 2x plus y plus 2 root 2 z cube square. Now, or because first term is not negative anywhere, so what you have to write? That is our answer. So, out of 16 sums are there, I am completing 5 sums. And anyhow, you have to complete these 5 sums. So, the first lecture homework is exercise 2.5, question number 1 to 5 in your fair book and rough book.